It's time to hit the water with underground quality kingpin, Jus-Ed. This DJ, producer, label head and family man has built his career from the ground up with minimal fuss, forging meaningful relationships and all the while staying true to himself. The trademark Jus-Ed deepness has been sitting in the pocket between house and techno for over 10 years, and alongside the tight stable of meticulously signed artists, has continued to push the underground quality message further forward. So let's get on board and have some fun. So we're enjoying a bit of sun, just hanging out with DJ Jus-Ed from Underground Quality.
Yes. What's up, Matt? Nice to meet you. Thank you.
We're hanging out and
enjoying
a bit of sunshine.
Yes.
A bit of a family style.
Yes. Over the years, I found out I'm an educator. I like to educate people, explain things.
Yeah.
I enjoy exploring new things. But I like seeing it. The information that I give people or share my personal life experience, it's really rewarding to see them catch on and grow. Man, this guy's a machine, man. Fuck.
Oh, yeah, he's killing it.
Yeah.
We're racing.
Slow down over there. Fuck.
We're breaking a sweat here already.
Oh, shit.
But, yeah, we're going to be sweating bullets by the time we hit that tree.
Yeah.
But, that's kind of the picture that I had.
Just
from listening to...
Yeah.
Just from listening to your records and understanding your vibe, that's kind of the picture that I had. It's kind of like how... more than anything, was like how that attitude translates to, you know, the Underground Quality family, you know? That was the...
Yeah, you're right. I mean, it's very close. It's like the introductions, the conversations, the friendships, you know, it's like very family orientated. I mean, that's the bond that glues us together, the blood bond, is the fact that we're friends. So like in the past, people have, in the industry, you've seen your favorite group or your, you know, favorite DJ or favorite label. You see them break up. And it's because, I don't know, I don't think they were really friends. It was the business.
Yeah.
You know, so, I don't befriend, I'm friendly, but I don't befriend people because I've been hurt and taken advantage of, let down over the years. So I don't, that pedal is a little bit too loud. Are we getting feedback from that pedal?
I think basically what we're trying to say here is let's slow it down a touch.
Yeah, just a tad. I can't think and keep up.
Let's float for a bit. How about we float?
But no, it's good. I need to exercise. Yeah.
So it's getting blood pumping.
So yeah, I mean, the ties, the relationships between all the artists on UQ.
We can chill now, we just got the signal,
okay.
We can chill.
Cool. is just that, you know. We're always checking in. I'm usually one that's always checking in with everybody.
Yeah.
To make sure they're okay, or they got some good news, they got another interview, or they caught another, you know, good release. Kids, marriage, relationships, even breakups, you know, struggles. Yeah, we're there for each other. We'll pedal a little bit further.
I think that's very visible from the outside looking in. I think it's very visible that, you know, you are like the Underground Quality dad, you know. It's very much, you very much sit on, you know, you've got a tight unit and it's really visible from the outside.
Well, this is one of my character assets is that I do care, you know. I care about people, I care about what's going on, especially people that are close to me, you know. And we have the same drive or dreams or purpose in life, you know. Then I want to do, I'm always checking, you know. But you know, you can always tell me to fuck off, and and I will, you know. Not easily. Yeah. Not easily.
You're not going down without a fight?
Yeah, no, yeah.
You're gonna fight a bit.
Yeah, I think we're drifting back now.
We are drifting a bit back, but it's all right. We're kind of, the wind is,
the wind's wind is beating
taking
us
just a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, stormy seas.
Yeah.
Where we left off a little bit, besides the boating troubles.
Yes.
I think the optimum word that I got from what we just spoke about was care.
Yes.
And I think from that comes the idea of your mentoring and, you know, you're you seem like the advice giver, especially to the new kids that are, that you encounter, or is that the case? It looks that way, but is that really the how it is?
I'm more concerned about being perceived as somebody that knows it all. So I'm always like careful about how I answer these questions.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I don't. Actually, there's a few artists that have educated me, and I was embarrassed actually, because I don't know everything, but I never professed to know everything. But I've been around long enough where I know more than the average person that's just starting out. So the stuff that I've learned in the business, I'm very good at, and I'm very firm when I give the instructions. But I'm honest though.
Yeah.
If I don't know something, I don't know. You know, I try to find out. Try to find out what's going on.
Slow down, homie. Slow down before he dies. We wanna keep all boat members alive at this point. Captain doesn't want anyone to go down on the
senior boat members.
And I think that honesty and that openness is really refreshing at this point in time. You know, I think in this time, a lot of the output from people's personalities is a little bit, I don't know if you want to call it PR managed. I guess every person has their own PR style now with social media, etc.
Yeah.
Do you find that a lot, and do you find that it's that you're kind of swimming against the tide, being open and honest in this day?
Swimming against the tide. Yeah, I tread water for a lot of years.
Yeah.
But my thing is I'm anti press, anti this. I mean, I'm honored because I know this is a big exposure and everything.
Yeah.
But inside, it's a struggle for me because I'm an underground cat.
Yeah, yeah.
And the underground is always underground, regardless of how popular or, you know, you want to commercialize things. You find something good and everybody wants to share it with everybody, but it loses its value. It loses its potency when you cross over, you know? And I mean, I've studied over the years a lot of different artists in a lot of different genres, and the quality, there's very few artists that can actually keep the same quality that they started when they were underground or not so popular or, you know, being in demand is a different thing. Being underground and being in demand, you know, you can make a living. And you can still make your music and carry the purpose of what you were trying to do, or, you know, what your vision is for the label, culminate other artists. And because somebody asked me, you know, they were like, well, how do you feel about like several artists? They're actually more popular than you are. I never seen, and my reply is, I never seen a coach receive the most valuable player. Yeah. He gets Coach of the Year award, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not I was never interested in being the star, but you know, I do want people to know what I do, the brand,
the
style, and let people know that there's still, you know, there's honest people, there's good people all over the world. In the business, there is.
Yeah.
And there's good business. I do a lot of self-promotion, a lot of media network, you know, people that have asked to be my friend or they're fans of the music, and those are the people that I advertise to. So anyway, I hope that makes sense. Anyway.
Absolutely, because the label retains this kind of DIY approach to it.
Yes.
And that's a really credible thing in this age, you know? And I think it adds a lot, it does add a lot of value to it, there's no doubt.
Yes.
There's no doubt, and I think it's a credit because I'm guessing your learning curve over the last 10 years has been pretty steep.
Yeah, it has. I learned a lot. And, you know, the best mixtapes, the best records, is always black and white. You know, it's the white label. You know, it's black vinyl, white label. I mean, that was the purpose of Underground Quality in the first six or seven releases. The labels were all black and white.
I remember
white labels with black text.
I remember the little words on the bottom about the downloads. If you're seeing this download anywhere,
yes.
You know, I remember that press. I remember reading that press, and I was like, whoa. Man, this is serious. Like this is the real deal, and you could feel it, you know, just from those little things. And it wasn't like any crazy font or anything like that. It was just straight up.
Exactly. Pure. If you're keeping it real, then it's no effort. If you know who you are and you're a straight shooter, we say.
Yeah.
If you're a straight shooter, there's no effort in it. You do what you do. You do it. I mean, what puts muscle behind it, what puts power behind it is that I own my own label. I've earned the right now where I do my own distribution. I had my own website, you know, publishing, all of this stuff I own. So nobody can tell me what I should do or, yeah, this is better for the market and all that, whatever. This is what I feel like doing. And I have a solid fan base, people that love, they understand, they grew up with it. It's 10 years this year.
Man.
10 years with the label.
Love don't make you change. Love don't make you change.
From the outside looking in, Underground Quality looks like it's kind of more than just an outlet for putting out records. It seems like it's a holistic thing, if you want to look at it like that.
I mean, it's no secret. Everybody knows I've been incarcerated. And the last bid that I did, I've always knew about chess, but I actually learned how to manipulate the pieces, strategy.
Yeah.
And then I found out through the course of playing this game that I also am a visionary. I have not just dreams, but I have vision. I'm able to put this together. If this goes like that, that goes like this. If I do this, blah, blah, blah. The end result is success, not riches and luxury, but success from the meaning that I finished what I start. So we have a saying, A man that doesn't have a plan is only planning to fail.